on 2nd March, bought plant rupees 5,000, indicating you have purchased machinery worth 5,000. So machinery or plant, we say, is a real account because it is tangible. So when you buy machinery, real account comes in. So that is why we debit plant being a real account and coming in. So we say plant account debit. So we would have paid cash for it. Cash again real account, it is going out. So therefore we will credit cash based on the rule, credit what goes out. The amount being 5,000. Narration would be being plant purchased, being plant purchased. Now the next transaction is on 3rd. It is paid for postage 500, paid for postage 500. So again it's a cash transaction, that is cash is going out. And what we are getting postage. But postage is treated as nominal account because postage, whatever we buy as postal materials, they are not going to stay as with us for a long time. We don't preserve the postal materials or stationery, etc., for more than 1 year. Okay, so therefore the usage of this postal material is usually within the 1 year. So therefore it is treated as a nominal account. So being a nominal and we are buying, it becomes expense. So debit all expenses, the rule of nominal account says. So that is why we will debit postage. So we write postage account debit to, well, how we'll get, we paid for it. So cash is going out, real account is going out. So we are going to credit the cash because it is going out and it is a real account. So how much it is? 500. So our journal entry, postage account debit 500 to cash 500, being postage purchased or being postal items purchased. Now next transaction is on 4th, which is nothing but withdrew cash for office use. The meaning is whatever money previously you have put in money, some money you are taking out from the bank for office use. So it is withdrawal of money from bank for office use on 4th. So when you are taking out money from the bank, cash is coming into the business. So cash is real account, the rule is debit what comes in. So cash account debit, because from bank the money, cash is coming into the business. And next, what is bank? Bank is a personal account. So what is bank doing when you're taking out money from the bank? Bank is the giver of the money. So what is the rule of personal account? Credit the giver. So we are crediting the bank here based on the rule, credit the giver, bank being personal account, I repeat. Now, the amount being 1,000, the amount being 1,000, your narration would be being cash drawn for office use. Now, next transaction is on 5th. The transaction is paid for sundry expenses. Paid for sundry expenses. Now, what are sundry expenses? They are small expenses what you pay, and as a result, they become your nominal account. So nominal account and being expense, we have to debit it. So we say sundry expenses account debit. Paid means cash. Cash is real account, it is going out. So credit what goes out. So cash we are crediting because it is going out. So how much? 500. Narration you can write as sundry expenses paid, being sundry expenses paid.